Ladies and gentlemen, it's me, James Spinney, coming at you, not from Wall Street, but my West Coast trip on the way back home continues. And as you can tell on my head, I'm back here in Oklahoma, Norman, Oklahoma. Zombie Nation still lives. They're practicing for the stadium sound check, the Gaylord Stadium in back of me. You know what? It feels good to be back here. It's been a very long time. A little too long, to be honest with you. But to walk around, get some fresh air, hear the music, that same song from many years ago. Guess what, guys? I'm feeling great. You know what else is most likely feeling great too? The markets and those bullish investors. So let's take a look now to see how the markets are shaping up.
Now, Dow futures are pointing to a 150-point gain at the open this Wednesday morning after a rally to record highs this week took a little bit of a pause. The FAA cleared Boeing 737 MAX to fly again. The fleet had been grounded for nearly 2 years after two of the jets crashed and killed a total of 346 people. Pfizer and BioNTech said that a final data analysis found their coronavirus vaccine was 95% effective and appeared to fend off severe COVID-19. Also, at the same time, the FDA has approved for emergency use the first COVID test that can be conducted entirely at an in-home. The single-use prescription test from privately held Lucira Health provides results within 30 minutes. Lucira put the cost per test at around $50. And with Thanksgiving coming up next week, public health officials warning about the risk of a holiday-fueled surge in coronavirus spread, doctors are urging families to stick to small gatherings on Thanksgiving or to stay at home entirely. Meanwhile, Lowe's is sinking about 6.5% pre-market after the home improvement chain managed to report adjusted third quarter earnings of $1.98 per share, slightly lower than expectations, and a dimmer profit outlook. And then lastly, some advice, waterproof boots, they're special.